Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to another video on the channel where today we're going to be checking out the 4-2-4 and why I personally think this will be the best formation to use throughout Team of the Season. If you do want to see any more vids on the channel, let me know in the comment section and we will make them as quick as possible during Team of the Season. Make sure you do hit that subscribe button as well if you are new to the channel and are loving the content. But before we get into the video, I just want to let you guys know that we are going to be streaming. Obviously, Team of the Season is out tonight. We're going to be streaming that tonight on YouTube. Our streaming schedule is in the description, so go and check that out. The plan is to try and stream every day during Team of the Season, but the schedule is there. So if you want to come and check us out, be much appreciated. If videos are just your thing and you're not interested in streaming, that is okay too. But going into this 4-2-4 video, now I've had a lot of fun with this formation recently. I've been using it a lot to do the friendly objectives and I had a blast and found some incredibly good attacking tactics that will work so well for you. Now, a couple of things to note, this formation is exceptionally good against low to mid tier skilled players. So if somebody is maybe not quite as good. And it's also extremely effective against drop back. Now, one thing that you do need to be good at if you want to use this formation, you have to be good at 1v1 defending because there'll be a lot of times that you'll be one-on-one. A couple of examples of us being one-on-one, the ball gets stolen off us there by, I think it's Greenwood. And you can see a few examples here. We are 1v1 in three different occasions. Like I said, there'll be a lot of occasions where you are 1v1. So being a good 1v1 defender is really important. You've got to know how to defend 1v1 because that's the situation you'll find you in. But we do really well. We get the ball, we steal the ball off, and look at this counter. Look how slick and fast this counter attack is. And then Gomez ends up tackling us, and we do get a penalty, which we did indefinitely score. But there are a lot of occasions where you'll find yourself again. This time, 1v1 against the centre backs. One centre back's got to mark the other. So a lot of times you'll find yourself in this situation. 1v1 against another defender, and obviously that's something you've got to be good at, and we will have defending tutorials throughout Team of the Season. For me, 1v1 defending is something I've really improved at, and this is a prime example here. We've highlighted, I think it's Nedved and Florenzi, and we actually make a big error here. We stop running. We were tracking the run really well. We stop running. Nedved then ends up running by us. Now, this is where you have to be good as a 1v1 defender. This is where you have to realize your mistakes. We made the mistake with Florenzi, but rather than just, you know, fitting about it and you know, being all down and moaning, you got to realize that we look really quickly, and these are the snap decisions you've got to make while you're defending. We look on the inside, and we're marking our centre-back. We've got two players in the middle of the pitch, near the edge of our box, and he's marked already by that player we've highlighted. So we've got a free centre-back. So we have to realize really quickly that you need to get across, use that defender, get across and cover the run, because your fullback, i.e. in this occasion, Florenzi, is never going to catch up. So we have to realize that centre-back needs to get across. And that's exactly what we do. The centre-back gets across, makes a tackle, and snuffs out the play. So you'll find yourself in a lot of 1v1 situations. Now, going into our tactics, these are the tactics that I did settle on. Now, nothing new when it comes to the defensive style. Balanced, as we always use, pretty much always. And the width and depth is pretty much the same. The big change comes on the width on offense. We've got, we're on 9 out of 10, which is extremely wide. But obviously, having those four attackers up front, the two wingers and the two strikers, you will find a lot of really good opportunities. Not necessarily just down the byline, you know, when we whip those balls down the byline. Actually on the inside of the fullback as well, between your, for example, your right winger and your right striker, you'll find that there is a lot of channels in there as well, either side of the fullback, to be able to make lots of really good penetrating runs. You see a really great example here of Lucas. Now, I just want you to keep your eyes on Lucas. We've highlighted him here, and we've put an arrow to where he's going to run to. I want to keep your eyes on Lucas, and look at the space that he finds. He ends up shifting the ball off to Rooney, and just look at the way he drifts into that space. Walker finds him, and boom, look at all that space he is in. And that's what we're talking about, being playing on really wide. Unfortunately, it's a really poor finish from Lucas, but they find a lot of space. Now, another real key to this formation is obviously the fact that you have got so many bodies forwards in attack. You know, you've got so many players. These are the instructions that I have for the midfielders. In this occasion, we've got Tornsby and Nainggolan. We've got them on stay on edge of the box and cover center. Everything else is the same. I want them on balance. You could have them on stay back while attacking. This formation is meant to attack and to have fun. So I've gone for the balanced option. And you're just going to have so many bodies committed forward into so many attacks. You can see some great examples here of the fact that, you know, we have bodies flooding forward. This time Rooney tries to pass into Fred. Unfortunately, it doesn't quite come off. But you can see Five players there highlighted at the top end of the pitch in the business area of the pitch. So we've got plenty of choice when it comes to picking somebody out. We end up picking out Rooney, who then ends up, great low drilled finish into the corner. You just have so many bodies forward. Another prime example here, Moura on the right-hand side, good little give and go with Vardy. And again, look at those penetrating runs. And the thing is that makes this formation so difficult to defend against is that there are so many runs. Normally, when you do a give and go, you'll do a give and go on the wing, and you just have to, like you saw earlier with Nedved, you just have to track the runner. When you've got this many players running forwards, as you can see again, we've got three, four bodies tearing forwards, it makes it impossible to defend because you can't possibly pick up all the runners. And that is partly obviously due to the instructions that we'll get into for our attackers, but also that long ball technique, because long ball means they're going to run in behind as well on their own accord. This time we don't pick any of those players out. We decide to wait for Madison from the midfield to run. And in this occasion, all he has to do is just, if Madison can hold off that midfielder, we just need to play a simple ball in, which we do, and then Madison finishes it off really, really well. And again, that's their midfielders really getting involved. And again, another prime example, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 players at the top end of the pitch. And we'll get into the next example, it's really crucial. You might be thinking, what if you lose the ball? Is a counter-attack possible? You know, having so many bodies forward, can you get counter-attack? Well, here's a prime example that really highlights that. We've got 8 players in the box, but look at the bottom of the screen. We have highlighted the little mini-map. He only has 1 player at the top end of the pitch. We've got 2 defenders. So there is no risk of us getting counter-attack. Now, this tells me 2 things. This tells me, 1, he's either on drop-back 1 depth or he is on a really low depth. You know, everyone will come back on defense because he's only got 1 player at the top end of the pitch. So he can't possibly counter-attack us even if we lose the ball. So having this many players committed isn't a problem, and that's why we said at the beginning of the video, this is really effective against people that play drop back, because they're not going to have any players at the top end of the pitch, so you can afford to commit a few more players. There will be occasions that you'll concede counter-attacks, but a lot of the time, this is the situation you'll find yourselves in. We end up playing that ball back, I think it was to Nangalan, and again, he slaps that into the back of the net. So those instructions up to the strikers, we've got, obviously in this occasion, we've got Immobile and Lukaku, stay central and get in behind. Now, these are not the ideal strikers. If you really want those pacey, fast strikers like we were using with Jamie Vardy, you want players like that, you know, your Mbappes, Neymars, players like that, Ronaldo's up front, Eusebio's, Ronaldo's. You want those really quick players up front. Now, in the wing slots, we've gone for getting behind and get into the box for crosses. Obviously, getting to the box for crosses means those that box is really getting filled up with players. Now, we didn't decide to go for cut inside. The reason why, we've already got 2 strikers on the inside, so we don't want to make it too narrow. And obviously the fact that we've got 9 width on the offense, we want to really stick to that. So balance width is the way to go. Now, I don't want to go and stay wide as well. You saw that example there with Lucas. That was more on the inside of the fullback, whilst we'd still had a player running on the outside. So you don't want them on stay wide either, because then they don't get involved in the play and they won't make those runs. So balance width is definitely the way to go. And this just gives you so many good attacking options. Now, on the defensive side, you do get some problems. Now, you can see a couple of examples here defensively. We lose the ball with Vardy. Now, this is a little negative on the formation, obviously, defensively. We don't have those real protectors in midfield. When they do get forwards, obviously, that does leave you exposed. You can see that channel that we've highlighted. It's not there. There's no one there to protect. The back four is in a great position, but he's able to just slide a ball straight through the middle of our centre-backs because we don't have that CDM protection. But this time around, we do have Doucouré. We have a great back four. The position is in a great position. Doucouré this time is in a much better position. He's really in front of the back four, so he's not out of position. So when this rolls on, and you'll see that he's able to make the interception. So when it comes to defensively, it's kind of 50-50. You've seen plenty of examples where you will find yourself in many one-on-one situations and you need to be able to defend one-on-one effectively. You know, there's not going to be many options like that, like we saw with Doucouré, where he's going to be there to protect. That's kind of few and far between. Not necessarily few and far between. That's kind of 50-50. Half the time that will happen, half the time it won't. So you do need to be able to defend one-on-one pretty effectively. If you can defend one-on-one effectively in this formation, this is a fantastic formation. Now again, dropping back to those midfielders, we've seen there with Doucouré, does get in front of the centre-backs and does protect from time to time, but they really do get forwards as well and really give you more options going forwards. You can see a couple of really good options. Doucouré, nice one-on-one into Mkhitaryan. You're going to see Doucouré makes that run. He's tried to cover Mkhitaryan. He's pulled his centre-back out of position. Your eyes light up. You're thinking, this is easy, man. We're just going to drop this ball back to Doucouré. and he's going to be able to slot in behind, and then nice little shoulder drop, and then a great little low drilled finish into the corner. This time again, we pick up the ball with Tornsby, and again, this time it's going to be Nainggolan spinning in behind. We're going to play that ball into Immobile, the striker, and he's going to try and commit with his fullback, but not with his fullback, with his midfielder. Nainggolan's just going to slip in behind and then slap that one in the back of the net. So having all these options is obviously going to mean a bucket load of chances. Time to time, you're going to be left exposed. But ultimately, this formation for me, it's so much fun, man. And that's what this game should be about. It should be about having fun. And this is a perfect formation, like I said, to use against low to mid-skill players. When you come up against some really high-skill players, I'll tell you when this formation is not effective. This formation is not effective against people that play the game properly. If somebody's playing on, like, normally for me, I will play on 5-6 depth, you know, 5-6 width, balanced, that sort of thing. If somebody plays with, like, normal tactics and instructions, this formation it can easily be, you know, played around. Also, if they're a pretty good skilled player, that's when you can find yourself in a little bit of trouble with this formation, because whilst you still create a lot of chances going forwards, if that person is a pretty decent player, he's going to have, obviously, you see situations where we, you know, our opponent had one striker at the top end of the pitch and we had two defenders. In that example, if they're playing a little bit more aggressive with kind of more normal custom tactics, they're going to have maybe two or three players forwards. You've only got two players back. That's when you're going to find yourself in a lot more trouble. Even if you're a good 1v1 defender, you are still going to struggle. So this formation overall, it's so much fun. I had a blast using this formation. It's something that I'm going to really try out. I'm going to try this out in Weekend League next weekend when the Prem comes back. And I'm going to see if I can have a lot of fun with it and see if I can have some good results, because this is a fantastic formation and definitely is really effective. So if you want to use this formation, try it out. Let me know how it goes for you in the comment section. If you do want to see any more vids, let me know in the comment section as well. Make sure you do drop that thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button as well if you are new to the channel. And as I said, if you want to check out any of our streams, we'll be streaming tonight. It will be on the channel, so if you're subscribed, you should get a notification to tell you that we are streaming. But that is all for today, guys. Have an awesome day. I'm out.